Have you ever had a small bump grow on your eyelid? Technically, there are a few different types of these bumps. One of the more common ones may even appear almost like a pimple because it can be red, kind of painful, and even come to a head sometimes. That type of eyelid bump we refer to as a hordeolum, or commonly referred to as a stye. These types of bumps are technically an eye infection on the eyelid, which is usually minor and self-resolving in just a few weeks. However, there's another type of eyelid bump. This is called a chalazion. A chalazion is usually a harder, non-tender nodule, which is usually deeper and can slowly grow over time. In contrast to a stye or hordeolum, a chalazion is not an infection. Instead, it's just a cyst or a blockage of oils trapped within the eyelid. And over time, if those oils continue to grow and expand, it can make the eyelid rather large and inflamed, and that can even push on the eye, causing blurred vision. And the real challenge with chalazions is that they can last a long time, sometimes many months, and they can be a bit challenging to get rid of. Okay, so what causes a chalazion to form in the first place? Again, a chalazion is a blockage or oils that have been trapped within the eyelid, and this can occur for multiple reasons. Some people can form a chalazion after having a stye or a hordeolum in the eyelid that is resolved, but some people can just have a chalazion that occurs spontaneously. And there are some risk factors that increase the risk of getting these. Namely, are people who have a history of blepharitis or some forms of skin conditions like rosacea or seborrheic dermatitis. Now, we've covered blepharitis before on this channel, but in short, blepharitis is a buildup of dead skin cells, oils, as well as microorganisms that build up on the eyelid and then lead to inflammation and possibly infection of the eyelid as well. In more recent research, there's been a lot of attention to the presence of Demodex mites, which are a normal part of the human flora along the eyelid and lashes. However, some people are more prone to an overgrowth of these mites, which are linked and associated to an increased risk of chalazions or hordeolums, as well as meibomian gland dysfunction and dry eye disease. Okay, so how do you treat or remove a chalazion? Well, to get rid of a chalazion, we really have four treatment avenues. The first of which is doing warm compresses and using antibiotics. Doing a warm compress for 10 to 15 minutes, maybe 3 to 5 times a day, is probably the most conservative kind of at-home treatment for a chalazion. The whole idea is that the heat and a little bit of pressure is going to help melt any of the solidified oils within the chalazion, and then the little bit of pressure will kind of massage those oils out. Usually though, this is only really effective if it's the very beginning of a chalazion formation, so if it's in the first few days, maybe the first couple weeks. Otherwise, if the chalazion's been there for more than a month, it's unlikely that this heat and doing the warm compresses is really gonna be doing too much of anything. It's something that a lot of doctors will still recommend at any point, but again, just the likelihood of it resolving on its own with the heat is unlikely after about the first month. Sometimes eye doctors will prescribe antibiotics to help with the chalazion. A chalazion is, again, not an infection, but some doctors will write these antibiotics anyway because some types of antibiotics, like oral doxycycline, for example, is known to have an anti-inflammatory effect on the oils that may be causing the chalazion in the first place. More recent research has sort of cast doubt that these antibiotics may not be that effective and that they're just not causing a statistical significance at reducing the inflammation, but there is some evidence that it may reduce the risk of reoccurrence. So some eye doctors may prescribe it anyway. Again, the use of these medications along with warm compresses are definitely more of the conservative option and usually best adopted early on when the chalazion is first forming. A new treatment option that your eye doctor may be able to offer you is using IPL or intense pulsed light therapy. IPL is a light therapy that's applied to the eyelids and the face, which has been used therapeutically to treat things like rosacea, pigmented lesions, as well as treating dry eye disease due to meibomian gland dysfunction. And recent studies have shown a significant reduction in both size and reoccurrence when treating a chalazion with IPL, with success in most cases between 70 and 96%. It is important also to note that it takes on average between 2 to 4 sessions of IPL to reach these resolutions. So if you're expecting or trying to get rid of your chalazion really fast, this is something to consider with IPL. However, there are great other benefits with IPL treatments, such as helping with not only reoccurrence, but helping treat demodex, helping treat dry eyes due to meibomian gland dysfunction, and it also helps with smoothing out fine lines and wrinkles on the face. So again, all great benefits to consider. The last two treatment options your doctor may be able to offer you are a little bit more invasive. The first of which is an intralesional injection. This is where your doctor will basically give a local anesthetic around the chalazion and then give a small amount of steroid injected directly into the nodule. This will help reduce inflammation and help resolve the size of the nodule. In research, it's reported anywhere from 9% up to 90% effective, with an average effectiveness somewhere around 60 to 70%. Sometimes people do need more than one injection, but usually it is quite effective. The final treatment for a chalazion is called incision and curettage. This is where your doctor gives a local anesthetic and then applies a small metal clamp to the eyelid and flip it inside out. They then make an incision on the inside of the eyelid to drain the cyst. And then using another tool, they basically scrape out the remaining capsule of the cyst so it doesn't reoccur. Again, this is a little bit more of an aggressive procedure, but it does result in a faster resolution of the chalazion. Success rates for this procedure are reported between 60 and 92% depending on the study, but it is something that's often recommended if you have a chalazion that's been there for a long time, like several months. Of course, as always, it's best to consult with your local optometrist or ophthalmologist which procedure or treatment they think is going to be best for you. Okay, so what if you get a lot of these chalazions? What can you do to prevent future outbreaks? Well, the best way to prevent a chalazion is to have a good eyelid hygiene. And this includes having a daily routine of cleaning your eyelids with either an eyelid cleansing wipe or some form of a foam or eyelid cleanser such as hypochlorous acid. Another thing to consider is if you are somebody who has meibomian gland dysfunction or dry eye symptoms, is just doing warm compresses on a regular basis. If you need a warm compress or any eyelid cleaning wipes, you can check out helpmize.com, where we've put together a few different eyelid hygiene kits that you can check out. And if you choose to purchase from them, you can save 10% by using my code DEH10. Otherwise, you can always ask your local eye doctor and ask what products they recommend. From here, let me know in the comment section if you ever had a chalazion before and what sort of treatment options your doctor has offered you. Otherwise, if you want to learn more on how to do warm compresses more effectively or how to clean your eyelids for things like blepharitis, then check out the other videos coming up over here to the side. Otherwise, thanks so much for watching. Hope you have a fantastic day, and we'll see you in the next video. Peace.